Chairman of the Toledo Rice, Beans and Corn Producers Association, Dennis Usher, was one of those directly involved.
The production of rice in the Toledo district this year is going to be low. There are several reasons for that. One of the main reasons for the low production of rice is that some of the farmers had recently just received their balance of payments. Now, when the time for land preparation, they were not paid. When the time for planting, they were not paid. And so some farmers have just received their money. Their loans now have been approved, but the rains have come, and therefore the preparation of land cannot be done. So that's a big thing. And I think it all began with the sale of the heavy-duty harrow that I mentioned some time ago. That was the only heavy-duty harrow in the district. And that has gone, so it has slowed down the whole process of the planting and land preparation and everything. I brought these matters up to the ministry, and I spoke, the last meeting we spoke with Mr. Witt, he has not gave me a response on those issues. The thing we had confronted them with is simple. I want to know from early how the farmers will be paid this year. And that question was not answered. So we cannot go back to the farmers and says, well, they will be paid this price, or they'll be paid in one payment, two payments, because we have not gotten that response from Mr. Eugene Witt, and as he is in the meeting. And this problem, as I said, with the farmers is nothing new. The farmers were very skeptical this year because this has been going on for some years now. And the association has been trying to see how we can find a solution to work with the ministry to try and to solve this problem. However, as I said, you're getting distraction after distraction. When it should have been time for preparation, they're meeting and talking about grading system. What's the use of talking about grading system and you cannot tell the farmers how they're going to be paid? They haven't even been paid yet. So all of this had added up this year to the low production of rice. And compounded with the early rain that has fallen, some of the milpa farmers have not been able to burn, and some of the mechanized farmers, them who have started late, are not been able to prepare their land. So the production definitely this year is going to be a very, very low production this year.
Were there others involved in the assessment project with you?
Well, whatever we do, we definitely contact the Ministry of Agriculture, and as I said, the Agriculture Department down here. This association, we work closely, and as you notice, even last year, the figure we projected some 5 million pounds of rice, and last year was about that. And this year, we are projecting a low, because we have visited the fields, we have looked at the fields, we have talked to many of the farmers out there, and many of them, they want to plant, but if they have not collected their finances then. And like I said, I believe that when you look at the late payment, it was intentional, because it started from taking the harrow out of the district. Then secondly, not paying the farmers in time is simple to ensure that the farmers don't plant. So I think if that's the government's idea, was to slow down the farmers from planting this year, they have accomplished that. And as I said, the association, we continue to work with the farmers. Over the next few weeks, I will be visiting the area and visiting the villages, all the villages, and we will be sharing with the farmers all our discussions with the ministry. We'll be sharing all our discussions, whatever the association has been doing, and our way forward. But like I said, we are united, and at this point in time, I want the farmers to know that we are not calling any public meeting. So if anybody's sending any invitation for any farmers out there, we want you to know that do not accept it. It is not from the association. We will contact you, because we have been fighting for your payments. This association has been fighting for the farmers, and we will continue. We will step up a notch, because as I said, we have to apply pressure even more. We're grateful for the support of the two ear representatives who have supported us. Now we're looking forward for the support of the Chief Agriculture Officer, Mr. Eugene Witt. I think he needs to support and to respect the democratic process and to support the duly elected association, and I want him to get the message clear. This is time not to come up with distraction, but it's time to move it forward, because it's number one. If you do not support the farmers to plant rice, what is the government going to do? Are they going to send us a check every week? give me the alternative. I want the, Mr. Witt or the minister to give me an alternative. If you do not intend to support the farmers, don't so. What is the alternative?
OSHA further commented that while rice land preparation has been delayed and a setback to the majority of rice farmers in Toledo, a few others were able to have planted their rice fields already. According to OSHA, he is predicting that this year's rice crop in Toledo will not be as productive as expected, and he specified that this is unfortunate for rice production, which is considered a major industry in Toledo. Reporting for Love News, Paul Mahone, Punta Gorda.